Today I'm going to show you how I started off with a blank WordPress website, but recreated the New York Times website in just 30 minutes. And there's loads of great learning coming up, including how to create awesome mega menus, how to master layouts using a WordPress block theme, how to get complete control over your fonts and typography, and also how to create awesome post grids. Any logos or images that I use in this video are used purely for training purposes. Right, let's dive in. To make this simple for you to follow along, I've put my website over in the left-hand screen and the New York Times website over in the right-hand pane over here. And this is what I'm starting with over on the left. This is the 2024 theme, the default theme that comes with WordPress. Just running a fresh installation on WordPress.com. And let's log into my dashboard. So I'm going to go to Appearance and Editor here. And I'm going to start off by creating a brand new front page template. So click on Templates up here, Add New. And I'm just going to go front page. That gives me a nice clean canvas to build out my site. So I'm going to start by trying to create this row along the top here. And the way I'm going to do this is add the columns block and within that a few other blocks. So I'm going to start over on my site and hit the shortcut /columns. I want a 3-column layout. I can change the proportions of each column in a second. Then over in this left-hand column, I'm going to add the search block just like so. And if you choose this option here, it means that you only have the icon showing. And when somebody clicks on it, it expands so they can actually search. Then I've got this section here. I'm just going to use the row block for this one. So add the row block and then search for the paragraph block. And then it's just a question of typing these words in. You can also center this row as well. So just use the list view to select the row block itself. And then we're just going to justify to the center. And that should be nicely in the middle of our site. And then over here, we've just got these two buttons. So I'm going to go and add the buttons block in there. Now you can style these again just by coming in here and coming to styles, and you can change the size of them. Just put a custom size of 0.5 rems in for each of my buttons, and I'm just going to change the background color on them here. Again, you can do this in styles. I've just taken the color from the New York Times website and I'm putting the color in for each of these. Now I would normally put these in globally, but for speed today, I'm just putting them in each button. That's not too far away. And the other thing I want to do is just design this icon. You can change the background color of that. So I want the background color to be white and the text color to be black. And that just gives us more of the feel. And the final thing I want to do on this actually is I want to align everything in the middle so it lines up with each other. And we probably want to add a bit of padding above and below, a bit of margin above and below, just to give it a bit of space to breathe. And there we go. That's not too far away. I'm pretty happy with that. Next up, we've got this section here, which has got the logo and also the date here and also this DAO ticker over here. I'm going to keep this fairly straightforward. I'm just going to use another columns block for this. So I'm going to go add after, and I'm going to go /columns, and I'm going to use that 3-column layout again. And within this middle column here, I'm going to add the site logo. Now I'm going to have to extend the width of this slightly, but you can do that within the columns block itself. So if I click on these columns here, you can see over here, I can actually set the width either by percentage. So I'm actually going to do it by percentage. I'm going to do 25. And then this middle one, I'm going to do 50. Let's see how that gets on. And then this final one here, just make sure of your units here. And then this final one here, I'm going to do 25 as well. And that might give me enough space in terms of how I want the logo to fit. And I think it probably will. So I've already got the logo. So /site logo. And I'm going to upload my site logo, which I've got here, which I have got from the New York Times. You can change the size of it like so just by dragging it. Let's get it roughly the same. And the other thing you want to make sure you do is just to center it. And I think that's not far away. And then I'm just going to add the date into this one. I won't worry about the ticker today just because of time, because I want to crack on. But that's pretty accurate. Then under the masthead up here, we've got this little faint line. So I'm just going to use the separator block for that. So I'm going to use the list view and go add after, and then I'm just going to /separator. There it is already. And within that, you can actually style that so it's a wide line like so. And you can also style it so you can change the background color. So I probably want a light gray sort of color. You can use the color picker for this, or you can be really precise. I'm not being very precise, but you can see you can sort of change the color. And there we go. There's my faint little color. We got a bit too much space here, so I want to change the margin on that. Then under this, we've got the navigation block with these cool mega menus, which I'm going to show you how to do in a second. But first, let's add the navigation block. So again, I'm going to use the list view and I'm going to select separator, and go add after. And then I'm going to go /navigation, and that will add the navigation block in. So to reorder it, you want to click on it and click edit up here. That's essentially going to turn it into a menu. And now we have all our menu items here. These are all drag and drop, so you can actually just drag these up and down like so to change the order. Next up, I just need to center them using this little icon here, and I need to change the font size as well. So I can go into block styles here and change the font size. So you can change the size here, and you can also change the appearance. Click on the little three dots there and come to appearance, and this is where you can make them thin or light. So it's more in keeping with what we've got over there. It's not far away. I think probably I just want to resize them, change the size slightly down so they're a little bit smaller. Let's try 7. That's pretty good. I've missed out a few menu items, but I just want to get the spirit of the menus. That's not bad at all, is it? That's pretty close. Let's just finish off the header, and then I'm going to show you how to add a mega menu to your site. So I'm just going to select the navigation block and go add after. And in here, I'm going to add a separator block again, and I'm going to change the style, go wide here. And then after this one, I'm also going to duplicate that as well. So I've got 2. And then I think all I need to do on those is just remove the margin. So there we go. I've removed the margin on both of those little separators, and you can get this lovely little effect here. And then essentially what we've got over here, we've just got a row block with some paragraph blocks within it. So I'm going to select the separator block and go add after. And then I'm going to go /row to add my row block. And then I want to center that. So justify item center. And then I can just start to add these as little paragraph blocks in here. And then for the whole of the row block, I probably want to style those as well. So select the row block, and I'm going to go, let's see how we go. Yeah, small's probably about right. So that's not far away. So coming in WordPress 6.5 is you're going to have the ability to create mega menus like over on the right here. At the moment, you're going to need a plugin when 6.5 comes out from Nick Diego. I will put a link to it in the description for you. It's completely free, but this is how you do it. It's super easy. Just go click on edit site. You want to go to patterns here. So you go create template part here. And can you see here we've got this new template part of mega menu. So I'm going to call this New York here and just select that option down there and click create. And now essentially what you can do here is you can create any layout you like. So I'm just going to create a really quick one to show you the kind of principle of this. So just to show you what's possible in mine, I've added some columns and also an image, but there's literally no limitations on what you can design here. Now you can add that into your menu as a mega menu. Just come to the navigation block, click add block, search for mega menu. And there's a few settings in here you want to change. So this is your label. This is actually what's going to display on your menu. You can see up here, I've just added that one there. And then you need to select the menu template. This is what you created as that template part. And you can also change the width here. And here's my snazzy new mega menu. Pretty cool. And here's a few more examples of mega menus that I've built using exactly the same concept and the Nick Diego free plugin. Now we've got this section down here. Essentially, this is just using the query loop block to create really fancy post grids. So let's dive into that. So I'm going to select the whole header up here in the list view and go add after. And now I can start building out this page. Essentially, what we've got is just a 2-column layout with the query loop block in each column. So let's start. So /columns. And I want a sort of 2-column layout. That's close enough to start with. And then within this first column, I'm going to add a couple of query loop blocks. So I'm just going to click on the plus sign in the first column and search for query loop. There we go. And I'm going to actually choose a pattern to start with. Now, what we want is a pattern. And a pattern is a preset design of blocks. We want a sort of left-hand column with our title and our excerpt and then our featured image over on the right. Let's see if we've got anything close to that. That's looking pretty close, actually, although it's the wrong way around, but we can swap them around. So I'm going to start with that one, and that will just bring it in. But now we can customize this so it looks more like this. Let's use the list view for this. So if we dive into the list view, we can see what we've got. So essentially, we've got these 2 columns here. Now, I think I should be able to just swap those around. Let's see if that works. Yeah, so now we've got the featured image over here in the right place. This is the excerpt, which we do want, but we want to reduce the number of words. So we can do that like so. Just bring those up a little bit. The other thing that I think we can do is probably, let's just change the size so we can see what we're doing. It's not that far away. So we want a little bit of padding, and this is too big. So we want to make these a little bit smaller. Again, we can do that in the excerpt field here. We can just reduce the size, and we can reduce the size of our headings and make them more in keeping with the New York Times one. So let's just reduce those a bit. That's closer to it, and they probably want to be bold as well. So I'm going to click on appearance here, and I'm going to select bold. Yeah, that's not bad at all, actually, is it? That's pretty close. Let's have a look at that. I just want to do a little bit more tweaking on my excerpt and this title here. You can see over here, the line height's actually reduced compared to mine. And also the gap between the title and my excerpt is much bigger on my site. So I just want to change that. So I've selected the excerpt and I come across to line height here and I can squish that up a bit. That's a bit tight. And then I actually want to group these two first. So I'm going to use the list view to group them. And once you group them, it makes it really simple to do things like change things like the space between them, because you have this lovely block spacing feature here where you can just scrunch them up a little bit like that. You see, and now it's much tighter. That might be a bit close, so we can always dive in here and change that. But that's much more in keeping with the New York Times website. So the left-hand column's looking pretty good. I'm pretty happy with that, but I want to sort this right-hand column out. I'm going to show you a couple of really cool techniques that you can use on your own sites. Essentially, the way I'm going to do this is with two more query loop blocks. This one here is going to be one query loop block that's just set to show one post. This one down here is going to be another query loop block that's set to show two posts. So in this right-hand column, I'm clicking on the plus sign and searching for query loop. And I'm actually going to start blank. I'm just going to add the image, date, and title. Now I can remove any blocks within here that I don't want. So I don't actually want the date in here. So you can just select it and then just delete that. And this is the title block. And then underneath this one, I actually want the excerpt block. So /post-excerpt, or just excerpt rather. And that'll bring that in. And again, we can customize that. But the bit I really want to show you here is the fact that you can actually decide how many posts you show in that. So just select query loop here and come to items per page. And you only want to show one. Now, the other thing we want to do here is we want to show this one over here is actually going to be the third post. So we need to jump two posts. Otherwise, we're going to duplicate. Now, we can do that by choosing this offset here. So if I say two, offset two, it's actually not going to show the first post. It's going to show the third post. And in this query loop block, I'm going to remove this one. So then we'll have a natural flow between the two. So now we have our three posts showing on the page, but in different formatting because we've used the offset to say this post, skip two posts before you show it. Now I just need to add another query loop down here with two posts showing in it side by side. And my 30 minutes has run out, but I'm pretty happy with where I've got to. I've got the main spirit of the New York Times, I think. A reminder, my website is over on the left. This is just running the 2024 theme, so hopefully it shows you how customizable it is, and the real website is over on the right. I've got the header pretty much close. I showed you how to do those cool mega menus. And then this really cool trick in terms of creating these wonderful post grids using the query loop block. And I've emulated what this looks like on a mobile by squishing my left-hand pane over on the left here. And you can see it looks great because I'm just using the standard core Gutenberg query loop block, and everything resizes accordingly naturally out of the box. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that gave you a sense of the awesome power of WordPress in 2024. You can pretty much design anything with it just using standard WordPress these days. So if you did enjoy it, if you can hit that like button now, it'd be amazing because it makes a huge, huge, huge difference in terms of how many people get to see this video. It really, really does. So thank you. If you can hit that like button. If you want to see more videos like this as well, hit that subscribe button and you'll be notified when we release a new one. Keep well, and I'll see you soon. Bye for now.